Here I have the iFlight Blitz 20x20 6S 55 amp stack. I'm extremely excited to throw this in a Shendrone Squirt V2 that I'm building, and it should be capable of some freestyle once it's in there. I used to have a 30x30 50 amp stack in my other Squirt, but when I upgraded everything to digital, I ran out of room inside. So now with this 20x20 iFlight stack, I can have that power again and keep the Caddx Vista. So when you receive this in the mail, it comes in two little boxes. One's the ESC and one's the flight controller. One cool thing about this Blitz Mini F4 flight controller is that you won't have to solder to it at all. It has five plugs on it, and you can use these to connect your Vista, your VTX, your camera, GPS, beeper, receiver, pretty much anything you'd need to connect to a flight controller. There's a plug that you can use on here for it. So on this side, we have the USB-C right here. Over here, this plug is actually for the Caddx Vista. This plug right here would be used for the receiver. On this side, this plug right here connects to the ESC, which we'll cover in a minute. And then these two plugs right here, you can use for LEDs, a beeper, and a GPS, I believe. I'll flash a pinout for each plug on the screen right now. Now, obviously in the box, it's gonna come with all the different little plugs that you need. And these will go to the receiver, to the Caddx Vista, to the ESC. Pretty much everything you need is right there. And then you also have these rubber grommets to dampen it when you mount it to the board. Now you're probably saying, well, TronCAD FPV, what if one of the plugs rips off when I boof my drone into the ground? Well, iFlight has actually put additional pads that you can solder to over on this side right here. On this column of pads, you can hook up a Caddx Vista or air unit to UART3, and on the very bottom, they actually have the pins that are in this plug right here that you would use for the receiver. So you have access to UART2, not only through this pin, but through these pads over here. On the very bottom, you have an SCL and an SDA pad for a GPS. The flight controller comes with all the wires you would need to use these plugs. This flight controller has an MPU 6000 gyro and onboard black box of 16 megabytes. The stack is the F4 version, but iFlight does make an F7 version, which is extremely similar, but an additional $40. The board weighs about 5 grams. Now onto the ESC. So this one is significantly heavier. This one has a little bit more to it. We have the screws. You get an XT30 and an XT60 connector. You get rubber grommets. You get two spare capacitors, which are 470 UF 35 volt capacitors. And obviously the ESC, and then they give you a little ribbon cable. Now this ribbon cable is also included with the flight controller, so you basically just get a spare. So this is really the only board that you'll have to solder to when you're working with this. You'll have to solder the motor pads, obviously, and then also your battery lead. Since it comes with an XT60 and XT30, you can kind of choose what kind of battery you want to use with this drone. I use XT60s on my Squirt, so I'm going to use the XT60 version when I'm building this drone, but it's nice that it comes with an XT30. So when you're installing this in the drone, I initially thought that it was supposed to go like this, but each motor is labeled. So we have motor 3, 4, 1 and 2. So actually the board is gonna sit like that and the capacitor is gonna be facing down. So that way you have motor 1 over here, 2, 3, 4, and then the battery leads are facing up. They're both kind of a different shade of blue. It's kind of interesting. So now I'm gonna put this stack in the Squirt V2 that I'm building, and we'll take it outside and see how it flies on a stock tune with 55 amps. Thank you. right, so that footage was obviously not freestyle footage, but I figured it would be a little more entertaining to watch than just freestyle stuff. I actually took this drone out and filmed some light freestyle footage and was very surprised with how I performed on a stock tune. That flight that you just saw wasn't the drone's maiden flight, and I did lower the filtering a little bit to reduce motor heat. Otherwise, that was completely stock PIDs. It's awesome that this flight controller is almost completely plug and play. It makes repairs and assembly very easy, and then even if something happened to these plugs, you have pretty much any pad you need right over here. You got a lot of pads to work with, and you can even hook up a GPS, a beeper, LEDs to the thing, so you have plenty of pads to work with for a 20x20. I also really like how this capacitor sits on the bottom of the squirt. So that's completely flush. I have the flight controller sitting on these 20x20 holes right here, so it's right behind the camera, but the way that that capacitor sits, it's lined up perfectly with this little square. Keeps it very, very clean. So yes, very happy with this board, and I currently have no complaints. If I do run into any issues with it, I'll update the description of this video. That go-kart footage was a little teaser of an unreleased project that I worked on a couple weeks ago that'll be publishing sometime within the next week or two, maybe three, I don't know. Sometime soon, keep an eye out for it, it's a pretty cool project. But yeah, if you enjoyed this video, make sure you subscribe to the channel and like the video. And if you have any questions or if I missed anything, leave it down in the comment section. I try to reply to as many comments as I can. Okay.